Hello, everybody. How are you guys doing? I kind of want to make a video about this and that and everything and what's going on right now here in little Denmark. I haven't been listening to that much vinyl and music lately. And there's a difference or different reasons for that. But I've still been watching you guys' videos, but not as much as I used to. Partly that is because now I don't have so much money. Every time I watch you guys' videos, there's some records that I want, and I just can't handle that at the moment. Seeing all those lovely vinyl records, and then I just can't have them. So that's. That's kind of why, and there's also this other thing. I don't know if you have heard about this thing called Loudness Wars. I've just discovered this 2 or 3 months ago, and I have kind of lost faith in the music business right now. Maybe I should try and explain what the Loudness Wars is. It has got nothing to do with the loudness button on your stereo. But ever since the CD came out in late 82, things have started to go downhill sound-wise on music, how do you say it? Music productions. They have gotten louder and louder and louder and louder in the mastering ever since. And these past, probably since the 2000s, they have been so damn loud. And that's everything. CDs and vinyl records and stuff like that, and when they make the mastering louder and louder, there's no headroom in the sound anymore, so things sounds muddy and compressed and stuff like that. And then I tried to read about this Loudness War on the internet and watched a lot of videos, and I have just, why the fuck does artists allow these productions to get sold? It's kind of hard to talk about because I doesn't have the language. But I have a picture that I would like to show you guys here. So as you can see here, I have made, or I will show you some songs in wave form. And as you can see, there's 3 songs here. The first one is Lou Reed, Walk on the Wild Side from 1972. The middle one is Pink Floyd, Wish You Were Here from 1975. And the third one is Queens of Stone Age, the No One Knows from 2002. And the first one, as you can see, is there's a lot of headroom. It's actually quite low in the volume, but it sounds absolutely fantastic. And so does the middle track, which was Pink Floyd, Wish You Were Here, from 1975. Again, a lot of headroom, and that makes the sound sounds great. And yeah, it's really hard to say why, but as you all can see on the last track with Queens of Stone Age, there's no headroom and it's actually totally blocked. You can see there's parts where there's no headroom at all, and there's actually sounds that have been removed because it has turned up so loud. And lately, since the 2000s or something like that, actually most music that have been released is like this. Maybe not as much as this one, but I just can't believe that artists will allow this. They spent years and years on doing their albums and then mastering, and I don't know if it's the mastering or what it is, but the guy that is doing the mastering are clearly told by the record company to turn it up so they will be louder than the other band, so they will sound louder, and people think that the music sound better when it's louder, but it's not. And another thing about this, when you think you are buying a new remastered version of a great album and you think that it sounds better, it doesn't. It's just turned up so it actually doesn't sound any better. But people think that it does that when it's louder. So maybe I should stop the rant now, but this is one of the reasons that I haven't been listening to a lot of music lately, because of this. And I know there's some artists out there that are doing something about this, and there are these audiophile pressings that are better, like the MoFi pressings. They are mastered, so there is this headroom and it sounds fantastic. But pretty much all new music is compressed like shit. So I really can't believe that this is happening and have been happening for many, many years. Enough of that. And I actually haven't been listening to a lot of vinyl lately. I have rediscovered some Danish artists, like what we are listening to right now, which is Big Fat Snake. Some absolutely fantastic blues rock. And they have made a lot of albums. I can show you some of them here. As you can see, they have made quite a lot of albums, and actually I think they have made 7 or 8 more than I have here, but I stopped listening to them in the late 90s, but I've kind of been listening to their early stuff again, and it's absolutely great. Cheers! I've also been listening to Dizzy Miss Lizzy. Just late last month, it's the 1st of November today, but in October, they announced that they are getting back together in 2015 and will make a reunion tour, and also they have made some new music that probably will be released, so I have been rediscovering these three, or they actually only made two albums in the 90s. This is a live album on another reunion tour from 2010, but these two albums right now, these two albums are the best albums in the world. To me, it's just so great. It's kind of heavy prog rock with only drums, bass and guitar, and Tim Christensen on guitar, he's just absolutely phenomenal. The things he does on these three albums when he was only in the 20s, 21 and 22 or something like that. I just can't believe that that they pulled that off back then. But that's absolutely great. So that's kind of what I've been listening to. So what have I been doing these last couple of months or something like that when I haven't been listening to all that music? I've kind of been rediscovering an old hobby of mine, which is photography. I have been dusting off the old Canon 50D here, and I kind of lost interest in it some years ago because I didn't really have anything to take pictures of. I could go out on trips and just take pictures of the landscape and take some macro pictures, but I didn't really have anything to take pictures of. But then my son have kind of this last year been starting to get interested in birds. Because he have been that, we have been taking these trips just to get out and been birding, watching birds. It sounds pretty boring, but it really isn't. And then I found out that that in these fall, all of these birds are migrating south for the winter. And especially the birds of prey. I have a book here with the birds of prey in Denmark. And I have just been finding out that these birds are absolutely beautiful and majestic. And I kind of find it very interesting that they are flying south and flying several thousands of kilometers just to spend the winter, and then they are flying back again in the autumn. So I've been trying to learn these birds of prey, all the different kinds, eagles, buzzards, falcons, and what there is. So that actually gave me an opportunity to take pictures again, or photos, or what you say in English. So and these last 14 days, I've been out watching this migration six or seven times or something like that. And the only thing that I'm missing right now is some bigger lenses. The only or the longest lens I have is this 100 millimeters, and that's not enough for bird for photography. But the other day I was very, very lucky that some of these common buzzards were flying almost right over the top of my head, so I got some pictures. I can post a couple of them so you can see it, but I find it absolutely fantastic at the moment. So my interest right now is in for photography and watching these birds of prey. Of course, music will also always be a part of me, and I will still watch your videos, guys, and I will still make videos. But right now, I will probably take a little break. So that's how the state of Denmark is. I don't know if you can say that. Lastly here in the video, I found out that over in the US there's these Danish colonies, small Danish colonies. There's a place called Elkhorn in Iowa and Solvang in California. So a little bit of Denmark is actually in the US too. So lastly, I would end by saying cheers to the Danish colonies. And have a nice Halloween weekend, everybody. Bye-bye.